Hello everybody, this is Stephanie from Razzle, Dazzle, Rabbitry and Yarns LLC. Today we're going to start our crochet along for this little bunny. And we'll link all the materials that you need below. We do have our pattern that you can purchase. We've got it all down to a one-page pattern. And today we're going to start by making the tail. We're going to do an ear and then the arms. So tail, ears, arms. We have our yarn bowl, our yarn, our hand spun yarn. We start out with a slip knot. We have our size F hook, and we've got it on. So the first thing we're going to do is, you can do a magic ring, the magic loop method, and you want to single crochet 10 onto that first stitch. And on the first stitch, you want to place your marker. So there's one single crochet. And our stitch marker is on. There's smaller stitch markers if you want those, but these work very well. That is the first round. Next is an entire round of increases. So we want to end up with 20. So you just follow along on your pattern. We go from 10 to 20. We move on to round three. We're going to decrease all the way back down to 10. So if that's a decrease, I should probably do a decrease. Let's do that again. So there's two different ways to do a decrease. There's invisible decreases and there's your regular decrease. For this pattern, I'm just using regular decreases. All right, approaching the end. And then what we want to do is the round four, we want to decrease five more times. We'll get down to five stitches, we bind it off, and then we just set it and set it aside for later. So let's do our last row of decreases on the tail. Get to the end. So if you want in your tail, this is a little tip, you can put a little bit of stuffing in there if you want like a really puffy tail, but I like a tail that is kind of, it sticks out a little bit from the rabbit, but it's also a little bit flat on this bunny. So this tail has no stuffing. If you want it a bit bigger, you can put stuffing in it. So the way I bind it off, very simple. I cut, you don't need to leave a long tail on this. And I just hook it through the last stitch. And that's it, that's your tail. So next, we need to make two ears. We do another slip knot. You can do your magic ring, magic loop method, but you basically start out round one, add six stitches on. Always put your stitch marker marking the first stitch. There we go, that's the first round. Next, we're gonna do increased single crochet. We'll end up with nine. So we're just following along the paper pattern. Finish that round, we go right on to round three, single crochet all the way around. You're gonna still have nine stitches. Move on to round four, increase single crochet, repeat that and you'll get to 12 in this round, 12 stitches. And single crochet around for round five. round six, we need decrease single crochet. That's going to get us down to 8. Round 7, 8, 9, and 10. It's just single crochet around. That was round 7, now this is round 8, same thing. Now we do the same thing for round 9. And round 10 is the same as well. Round 11 is a decrease single crochet, decrease single crochet, decrease. That gets us down to 5. This is when it gets a little bit hard to work because it's such a small area. Hard to put the finger through and then the hook through sometimes. And next, rounds 12 and 13, single crochet around twice and then crochet over the opening and we'll set it aside for later. So this is, we'll do 10 stitches around. last stitch of round 13. Now we will crochet over the opening. So we'll get about 2 stitches in here, that's about it. What we do is we loop through 1, all the way through to the other side to crochet over the opening. We just do a single crochet. And then our binding off is the same. We just cut, we don't need a long tail. So this ear is done. Your ear ends up looking a little bit like that, an exclamation point, the top of an exclamation point. And then you make 1 more ear. After you have 2 ears, you're gonna make 2 arms. You start again with tying a slip knot and adding it onto your hook. Do your magic ring or your magic loop, method. To start out, round 1, get 6 stitches. On your hook. Same thing, place your marker in the first stitch. Next, we're going to increase single crochet all the way around. That's going to end up with 9 stitches. And then for rounds 3 to 10, we just repeat single crochet all the way around. This is round 3. This is round 4. 9 single crochet all the way around. Let's double check that round. We have 10 in that round. If you ever make a mistake like that, you just go all the way back to the beginning. It's just easiest. So let's start round 4 again. stitch 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we should have 4 left. Next, round 5, same thing. Round 6. Round 7. Round 8. Nine. And last, we've got round 10 in that sequence. So after round 10, we want to stuff. We have a pretty big bag of stuffing. We don't stuff the hand super, super full. So we'll start out just with a little bit. Add the stuffing in. Sometimes if you have a different crochet hook, or if you just take the loop out, you can get it stuffed in there all the way to the paw. I'm going to include just a little bit more. Then the round 11 is a decreased single crochet. You end up with 6 stitches. That's what we're going to do now. Now we crochet over the opening and we'll set this aside for later. We'll end up about 3 stitches. We go all the way through, do 1 single crochet, 2 single crochets, then 3 single crochets, that little bit, and we hook it through. There we go. There's a little arm. So then we make 1 more arm.